guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today, as you can tell from the title, we are going to be doing a Battle of Maybelline Mascaras video on the brand new Maybelline Sky High Mascara versus the ever so popular and my personal favorite drugstore mascara, the Maybelline Lash Sensational. I have done a first impression video where I tried the Sky High and I absolutely loved it, but the Lash Sensational is my all-time favorite drugstore mascara. So I figured we would do a side-by-side, compare claims and reviews, etc., and see what one is really the best. If you're a fan of the Lash Sensational, will you like the Sky High? Without any further ado, let's get into testing out these two Maybelline mascaras. So first up, we are going to go over Sky High claims. This mascara retails for $12.49 on Shoppers, but is currently on sale for $9.99, though it is currently sold out in all shades. In terms of product amount, you got 7.2 mls in the Sky High and 9 milliliters in the original Lash Sensation. And the Sky High is a continuation of the Lash Sensational. You will see if you own it, it says Lash Sensational down the side and then it says Sky High. So this is a continued elevated version of the OG Lash Sensational. So we're gonna see the differences, how they pair up. So let's get into product claims. Sky High Lengthening and Volume Mascara for Sky High Lash Impact from Every Angle. Long lasting mascara delivers full volume and limitless lash. Impact from every angle. The exclusive flex brush reaches every lash. Full volume, limitless length mascara formulated with bamboo extract and fibers. So long lasting, volume, and sky high length are the main claims. I will say I did not get much volume when I used this the first time. I would say I get more volume from the original Lash Sensational. So it's interesting to me that the Sky High claims volume. And then I would say the main difference is definitely the brushes. I will do an up close in a second, but this brush is an ultra flex brush. Some people have issue with that. They find it harder to apply. I personally really enjoy the ultra flex brush. I find it easier for applying on the bottom lashes. Now the original Lash Sensational mascara is $10.49. Again, comes in three different shades. All of them are currently available on Shoppers Drug Mart. All right, so this brush advertises a full fan effect. Patented fanning brush with 10 layers of bristles captures lashes from root to tip. So there's no real claims about length or volume. It just says that it's going to give a full fan out effect and that the brush is specifically designed to give that fan effect. So we have the Lash Sensational, the original with that more fanned out effect, short bristles, and then the Sky High with a more thin, long brush. Again, thin bristles. Both are rubber bristles and both are fairly long mascara applicators as well. So from going through the claims and looking at the products, we know that both formulations are quite wet rather than a dry formulation right off the bat. Obviously they will dry out with continued use, but when you first purchase them, they are going to be quite wet, and both of these are quite new, so they are quite wet. And both are plastic bristle brushes rather than real hair, and they both have quite short bristles, which is going to make the brush really grab onto the lashes. So I think we should just dive into it and try it both. I'm going to use my Lash Sensational on my right and my Sky High on my left, and we are going to try and do a similar coating of each. So let's start out with the Sky High and see how we like it. I will say that I think it's interesting that the claims indicate that you get a lot more volume with the Sky High. I find that I get way more length than volume with the Sky High, and I personally think that I get more volume with the original Lash Sensational, but we will see. So I'm not going to curl either of my lashes either, as I don't typically curl my lashes. It's just not something I really do in my practice, so I'm not gonna do it today. And I will be applying both mascaras with the same technique that I always use for my lashes. I always start at the base and then wiggle the brush upwards. And then once I have my lashes mostly coated, I like to do a little bit of back combing on my lashes. So I like to take the brush and start at the end of my lash on the back and kind of back comb to add a lot of volume on the end of my lashes, if that makes sense, on the very tip. That there is how I'm going to leave the lashes on the Sky High side for the top lashes. I will do the bottoms at the end as well. I really, really like this mascara. From what I can tell from using it now my second time, I honestly think I do like it more than the Lash Sensational, the original, which is why I wanted to do this side-by-side comparison. I just feel like this gives me more length and more defined lashes, but it really doesn't give volume, as you can see. It's really more about length and definition. I do like to build up my mascara quite a bit. Some might find it like spidery and clumpy. I personally like my lashes to look like this, so that is a couple coats with the Sky High. I really, really like how that looks. Now I'm going to go in with my Lash Sensational, which I'm predicting right away should give a little bit more of a fan effect in the outer corner of the eye, but I also predict that this is going to give me a touch more volume than the Sky High does. I definitely do find it slightly more difficult with the Lash Sensational to get definition on each lashes. I find that this mascara, just the way the wand is, tends to group my lashes together a little bit more. And here we have the original Lash Sensational applied versus the Sky High. I think you can tell in the camera that you definitely get more volume, especially at the root, with the original Lash Sensational, and I would say that you do get a little more of that fan effect. But as I said, as I was applying the mascara, I feel like it's definitely more prone to clumping. You can see some of these lashes are clumped together, whereas the Sky High is really, really good at separating and defining each individual lash. I also feel like the Sky High, my lashes look longer on this side. These ones to me look like they're a little bit more clumped together and stubby. All right, now that we have the top mascara applied on both eyes, I'm gonna go ahead and do the bottom mascara. Here is how the mascara is now looking applied top and bottom on both sides. Again, Sky High on this side, Lash Sensational on this side. Let me know what you guys think. Have you tried both of these? I know a ton of people are so loyal to the original Lash Sensational, and this has been my favorite hands down mascara for years and years. But looking at both sides here, I really do prefer the Sky High side. I do think it would be interesting though to try it using Sky High as the base for length and separation, and then using the Lash Sensational afterwards for a little more volume and fan effect. I think that would be really cool. So let me know if you tried using both together, how it turned out for you. I do definitely recommend both, but for my personal preference, liking length and separation, I think as of now, I do prefer the new and improved Sky High. I really, really like this formula, but again, if you like volume, I don't think this gives much volume at all. So definitely give this video a thumbs up, a like if it was helpful for you, if you learned anything today, or if you've tried either. Definitely comment down below, as I said, and let me know your thoughts. Also, let me know what side you prefer on me. I might change my mind when I'm editing, but as of now, looking in the mirror, I prefer the Sky High side. With that, that is all that I have for you guys today. As always, I hope that you either have or had an absolutely awesome day, and thank you so, so much for watching. Bye!